building realigns its outer
from the building. Is it doing a bit more of the specific outer building?
Or the building? The man who put up the money for the building, Sam Insull, was the king of electricity in Chicago. Basically, he started Commonwealth Edison. Now, Insull's throne is facing west, turning its back to the east. Why? Well, some tour guides would tell you because of Sam's daughter, an opera singer. She had auditioned for the New York Opera, and they turned her down. Her dad was so mad he built an entire building that looked like a giant chair, just so he could turn his back on New York City in a really big way. And that, my friends, is called a story. I would not believe a word of that silly story. The tour guides won't give it up. They've been perpetuating the myth for years. Yes, our death looks like a chair, but there's a history that wasn't mine. Right now, hold our head, Randolph Street. For the stroll east, you find yourself in Grant Park, where the whole world was watching Chicago 1968. The Democratic Convention riots, Abby Hoffman, Bobby Seale, the Chicago 7 right down there. Walk west, however, to the corner of Randolph and Des Plaines. Take a picture of Mary Braga's sculpture commemorating the most famous labor event in the history of America, May 4th, 1886 in Chicago. It was known as the Haymarket Affair. The labor activists in Chicago led the fight to the beat. Style, yeah.